Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 9th of September. India's COVID-19 tally crosses 4.3 million mark, 60% of cases from 5 states alone. Pakistan's former President Zardari, ex-Prime Minister Gilani indicted in corruption reference. And Afghan Vice President survives roadside bomb attack, at least 10 killed. And now for all the details. India reported 89,706 new coronavirus infections on Wednesday, taking its total case load to 4.3 million. According to India's health ministry, 60% of the total cases are from the 5 worst hit states, with over 20,000 cases reported from Western Maharashtra alone in the last 24 hours.
India reported 89,706 new coronavirus infections on Wednesday, taking its total case load to 4.3 million. India's Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan in a tweet said, 60% of the total cases are from the 5 worst hit states, adding that of the cases in the last 24 hours, over 20,000 are from Western Maharashtra alone. Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Uttar Pradesh, in that order, are the 5 worst affected states in the country. India's current COVID-19 tally stands at 4,370,128. Meanwhile, in the backdrop of the ongoing Unlock 4, partial resumption of activities in schools for students of classes 9 to 12 will be allowed from 21st of September. The Health Ministry issued guidelines to ensure smooth school operations. Students of classes 9 to 12 will be allowed to attend school on a voluntary basis for taking guidance from their teachers after taking written consent from their parents or guardians. Apart from mandatory masks, schools have to ensure regular sanitization.
Bollywood actress Riya Chakraborty was moved to a jail in Western Mumbai on Wednesday, a day after she was arrested on drug charges related to her boyfriend, actor Sushant Singh Rajput's death case. Rajput died in June this year and the case is still under investigation.
Bollywood actress Riya Chakraborty was shifted to Baikala jail in India's entertainment capital Mumbai on Wednesday, a day after she was arrested on drug charges related to her boyfriend, Bollywood actor Sushant Singh Rajput's death case. Chakraborty was sent to jail for 14 days during a video hearing by a magistrate who rejected her bail on Tuesday night. The 28-year-old actor spent Tuesday night at the Narcotics Control Bureau office. Chakraborty has been charged with organizing drugs for Sushant Singh Rajput, whose death on 14th of June is being investigated by the country's premier investigation agency, CBI. The actress' brother, Shovik Chakraborty, Sushant Singh Rajput's employees, Samuel Miranda and Dipesh Sawan, are also in jail for being in touch with drug dealers.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's former President Asif Ali Zardari and ex-Prime Minister Yusuf Reza Gilani were indicted by an accountability court in the Toshkhana or official treasury reference on Wednesday, while former Premier Nawaz Sharif was declared a proclaimed offender over his continued absence from the proceedings, according to local media reports.
An accountability court on Wednesday indicted Pakistan's former President Asif Ali Zardari and ex-Prime Minister Yusuf Reza Gilani in the Toshakhana or official treasury reference while declaring former Premier Nawaz Sharif a proclaimed offender over his continued absence from the proceedings. The National Accountability Bureau or NAB had filed a reference with the court against the trio in March, accusing them of misusing official gifts given to them by foreign states and causing a heavy loss to the national exchequer. According to NAB, during his tenure as Prime Minister, Gilani relaxed rules to allow Zardari and Sharif to buy expensive vehicles gifted to them at a nominal payment. The court, while declaring former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif a proclaimed offender, issued a perpetual warrant for his arrest over his continued no-show. The court also asked the authorities to submit the details of properties of Sharif, leader of Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz, within 7 days and adjourned the hearing till September 24.
Moving on, contingent and contractual employees serving in different government departments in Gilgit-Baltistan recently carried out a protest demanding job regularization. The protesters blame the authorities have kept on delaying the process for the past several years.
Scores of contingent and contractual employees serving in different government departments in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a protest against the Pakistani establishment seeking regularization of their jobs. Governor of Gilgit-Baltistan had signed the Contract and Contingent Employees Act 2020 in June to regularize over 6,000 employees. The protesters who gathered outside the secretariat office blame the bureaucrats are delaying the process.
15 saal se ye apne Gilgit-Baltistan government ko serve kar rahe hain lekin inki sunwai nahi ho rahi hai. Ab chuke ek bhi aa gaya, law pass ho gaya, ab us law ko implement karne mein kya masla hai?
Locals and government workers in Gilgit-Baltistan have to often hit the streets to demand even the basic rights. The illegally occupied region has also been swept by a wave of dissent in the last few months due to negligence amid coronavirus pandemic. People have not just been seeking their rights but challenging the decade-old suppressive status quo.
In news from Afghanistan, a bomb targeting Afghanistan's first vice president, Amrullah Saleh, has left at least 10 people dead and several others injured. Saleh, known for his anti-Taliban stance, escaped unharmed. Though Taliban has denied its involvement in the blast, this comes just ahead of long-awaited peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban in Qatar.
A roadside bomb in capital Kabul targeting Afghanistan's first Vice President Amrullah Saleh's convoy killed at least 10 people and injured 16 on Wednesday morning. Smoke from the blast could be seen billowing while emergency vehicles rushed to the scene amid traffic. Saleh, a former intelligence chief, escaped unharmed, but some of his bodyguards were among the wounded. Victims and eyewitnesses of the explosion narrated the gruesome incident.
کار خود می آمدم در منطقه تیمنی گذشته از جماعت خانه اسماعیلیه یک انفجار هولناک و مهیب بالای کاروان ما که می آمدیم قطار موترهای ما صورت گرفت یک تعداد از محافظین ما که مردان بسیار شجاعی هستند زخم برداشتند که به شفاخانه امنیت انتقال شدند.
The Taliban issued a statement denying involvement in the blast, which comes just ahead of long-awaited peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban in Qatar's capital Doha. Meanwhile, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, Abdullah Abdullah, chairman of High Council for National Reconciliation, and several other leaders condemned the attack. The presidential palace in a statement said that such attacks cannot weaken a strong will of the people for peace and that the security and defense forces will continue to fight terrorism. Abdullah called for a serious investigation.
In news from Nepal, on Wednesday recorded 14,868 active cases of the coronavirus with at least 306 deaths. With this, the country's recovery rate from the deadly virus has also increased in past 1 week. Recovery rate of Nepal had continued to slide to less than 55% by the end of August, but it has increased significantly from the starting of this month.
Recovery rate of COVID-19 patients in Nepal has increased significantly in the past 1 week, shows the country's health ministry data. On Wednesday alone, the Himalayan nation reported only 902 new virus cases and 2,287 people recovered across the country in the last 24 hours. Recovery rate of Nepal had continued to slide to less than 55% by the end of August, but it has increased significantly from the starting of September. Despite the improvement seen over the last 1 week, The health ministry has warned people not to flaunt the safety protocols and exercise high caution. Though the number of recovery and cases around the nation has continued to decline, capital Kathmandu is still witnessing surge in cases. Prohibitory orders have been in force in Kathmandu Valley since 20th of August in a bid to subdue the increasing virus cases. Local authorities, after failing to make a decision on whether or not to extend the ongoing prohibitory orders in Kathmandu, have sought directions from the Ministry of Home Affairs on the matter.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. A Sri Lankan lawmaker from the ruling party who was elected to parliament while serving a death sentence in a murder case was on Tuesday sworn in as the lawmaker by the speaker.
Premalal Jayasekara, a politician from ruling Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna party who was elected to the parliament while serving a death sentence in a murder case, was on Tuesday sworn in as a member of parliament by the speaker. Jayasekara was convicted in a murder case on 31st of July, just days ahead of the August 5 parliamentary elections, which he contested from the southwestern Ratnapura region. He was sworn in as a member of parliament by Speaker Mahinda Yapa Abewardena. Opposition lawmakers wore black scarves in protest as he took the oath. Several of them also staged a walkout. Jayasekara is the first convicted murderer to serve as an MP in Sri Lanka. He has been an MP since 2001. Jayasekara and two others were sentenced to death by the Ratnapura High Court for the murder of a political activist in the run-up to the January 2015 presidential election. He has appealed the conviction and the death sentence.
Moving on, two sisters in India's northeast and Manipur state are keeping the tradition of making dolls alive by crafting dolls of different sizes from discarded clothes and exporting them to foreign countries. The sisters now plan to expand their business so that they can employ more people to save the dying art.
Two sisters, Sushila Sorakibam and Ninthoi Ngambi, accompanied by some staff members, are keeping the tradition of making dolls alive in India's northeastern Manipur state by crafting dolls of different sizes from discarded clothes and exporting them to foreign countries. The vividly colorful dolls are locally known as Laipadibi, meaning a feminine image of God made from clothes. The Maitri community in Manipur's Imphal believes that Laipadibi has mystic powers and it is treated as a living spirit with feelings.
Kuire aina ping ai dege adum chap ma ho bare.
Manu inna sap chi karani ta.
Ai cha ba je akhoi gi imma baba dege adum tame. Si si kenna ba je akhoi gi thai ne gi oba potuna akhoi gi machak se hoji kan ji di na ho ai season ram ba da akhoi ma aina season ram ba da akhoi gi charu na season ram me hai do akhoi na khanga pada di charu du kadai de gi lo ne hoji di cha khol pai matung ina adunga ma mata mata ngi oi ba mo ong da cha na ba gi puthong na ba da mag da akhoi na spoil oi na season ram.
The sisters have received various state awards from the Northeast Zone Cultural Center and the government of Manipur. They now aim to expand the business and employ more and more people to save the dying art.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. India's COVID-19 tally crosses 4.3 million mark, 60% of cases from 5 states alone. Pakistan's former President Zardari, ex-Prime Minister Gilani indicted in corruption reference. And Afghan Vice President survives roadside bomb attack, at least 10 killed. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.